lovely. So welcome back to part two of McCall's M6838. So in this video, we will be sewing the skirt portion of this lovely, gorgeous dress. So the pattern pieces you will need, so let's go ahead and get to it. The pattern piece you will need is pattern piece number 9, 10, 11, and 12. So pattern piece number 9 is your skirt side front. Pattern piece number 10 is your skirt front piece. Pattern piece number 11 is your skirt back piece. And pattern piece number 12 is your skirt side back piece. So like I did in part 1, what I am doing is because I am underlining this skirt, I want the lace to show through. This is the first time that I am sewing a lace dress underlining. So what I'm going to do is place the lace on top of my fashion fabric. And with the side that I want to show up, I will place the lace on top. Go ahead and pin around all four sides and sew using a 1/4 inch seam allowance. I'm just basting it. I am not stitching it using permanent stitch. I will baste all the way around all four sides. Now that the underlining is completely done, I am going to take pattern piece number 9 and 10. With right sides together, I'm going to place pattern piece number 9 on top of pattern piece number 10, matching the notches. I'm going to stitch using 5/8 inch seam allowance from bottom to top. But first I'm going to pin, and then I'm going to sew using 5/8 inch seam allowance on both sides, the right and the left side, attaching the skirt side front to the skirt front. Now that you have sewn your fashion fabric, I'm going to do both the fashion and the lining the exact same way. So I know in the steps it tells you to do the fashion fabric first and then the lining pieces, but I feel like it's easier if you do the same thing at the same time. So I am grabbing the lining pieces, and what I'm going to do is do the exact same thing I did for the main fabric pieces. So with right sides together, place your pattern piece number 9, which is your skirt side front, on top of your skirt front. And go ahead and sew like you did with your fashion fabric with right sides together. Pin and sew using 5/8 inch seam allowance. And this is what it looks like, the front pattern pieces when I sew the front of the fabric, and this is the lining piece of the front. That's pattern piece number 9 to 10. So open it out, and this is what it should look like. Both your fabric, your fashion fabric, your main fabric, and your lining pieces. Now go ahead and move your front skirt pieces out of the way and grab the back pattern pieces, so which is 11 and 12. So first we're going to work on pattern piece number 11, which is your skirt back. So grab pattern piece number 11 and pin with right sides together. You're going to pin from the square to the bottom of the skirt. And you're going to stitch using 5/8 of an inch seam allowance from the bottom of the skirt to the square and leave an opening above the square. So do not stitch the portion from the top to the square. So you're going to do the exact same thing on your lining fabric from the square to the bottom of the skirt, pin and stitch using 5/8 of an inch seam allowance, leaving an opening above the square. And this is what it should look like when you have it stitched. And when you open it up, you will see from the square up, it should be open like that. So moving on, go ahead and grab pattern piece number 12, which is your skirt side back. Now with right sides together, what I want you to do is go ahead and stitch your skirt side back to your skirt back on each side of your skirt back. So you want to pin one pattern piece number 12, matching the notches to one of these skirt backs, which is pattern piece number 11. So you could just mirror what I'm doing right here. You're going to pin and sew using 5/8 of an inch seam allowance on both sides. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to stitch the skirt front to back at the sides. So with the right sides together, stitch the front pattern pieces, which is 9 and 10, to the skirt back pattern pieces, which is 11 and 12. So with right sides together and making sure that your notches match up, go ahead and pin the sides. And once you finish pinning the sides, using a 5/8 of an inch seam allowance, go ahead and sew the sides together. On both sides, of course. And this is what it should look like. The main fabric and the lining fabric. So what you want to do is go ahead and turn your main fashion fabric right side out. I'm sorry, inside out. And what we're going to do is with wrong sides together, we're going to pin the lining to the skirt, matching centers and seams, and then we're going to also baste the upper and back opening edges as well. So what I'm doing here is, what you're looking at is the lining side is the right side. And you're going to place the wrong sides of both the lining and the skirt fabric together, like you see me doing right here. So normally we sew things right sides together, but on this one, we will be basting with wrong sides together, the lining and the fashion fabric. So what I'm doing is I'm pinning around the opening first, and then I will pin around the top portion of the skirt, and then I will baste both the upper and the back opening edges together. Of course, using 5/8 of an inch seam allowance. And while you pin, make sure that your seams are aligned properly. So this is what it looks like once I baste it around the entire top, upper or top portion of the skirt. Now the next thing we're going to do is turn up your hem. Now I believe in the pattern instructions it says something like turn up 1 1/4 inch hem. Well, I am only turning up 1 inch because I do not want my hem to be that high and I don't want my skirt to be super duper short. So I'm only turning up 1 inch hem, but make sure to keep your lining free. So move the lining out of your way. And you're just working on your main fabric now first, you're going to, what I did is went ahead and measured out 1 inch, marked it, and then pressed it, and then sewed using a basting stitch. So for the main fabric, like you see me doing here, once again, I am marking 1 inch hem allowance. But for the lining, I will be turning up 1.5 inches for the lining because I do not want it to show underneath my main fabric. So this is what it looks like after I basted the main fabric and the lining fabric. And of course, I went ahead and pressed it as well. So the next thing I'm going to do, or we're going to do, if you're doing this along with me, we will be attaching the skirt to the bodice. So with right sides together, go ahead and pin your skirt to your bodice, matching the centers, keeping the bodice lining free. What I did is went ahead and pinned the lining out of the way so it's not in my way. And I'm going to stitch using 5/8 of an inch seam allowance. After stitching, you want to go ahead and press your seams towards the bodice. So you're going to press your seams up towards the bodice. But one thing that I do want to caution you about when you're attaching your skirt to your bodice, I sewed my skirt, I attached them in little sections. So what I did was I stitched a little bit of the center together and then stitched the sides together. Then that way I did not have to go using one continuously stitch all the way around. So this is what it looks like when I was done stitching, attaching the skirt to the bodice. And then I'm going to go ahead and turn it out. And you want to do the same thing to your lining fabric as well. So what you see me doing here is press the opening of my zipper. So what I did was with right sides together, I went ahead and basted from the top to the square using a basting stitch. Then I opened the seams, pressing the seams open so that way I could insert my zipper, which is the next step we will be doing. So make sure your zipper is closed. First, close your zipper. And you can see me do it here. I'm going to try to do it as slow as possible because I know some people have issues with zippers, putting zippers in dresses and things like that. So this is the easiest way for me to insert an invisible zipper. So with the right side of your zipper facing down. Make sure the zipper pull is out of your way. And then what I'm going to do is pin only on the main fabric. You do not want to pin through your dress, so just pin on the seam allowance section of the zipper. Pin and using a basting stitch, baste both sides of the zipper without going through the zipper teeth. Then what we're going to do is turn the dress right side out. Place a pin where the permanent stitches begin of your zipper. So I'm going to place a pin there so I know where to stop opening out my zipper. Basically, I'm going to take my seam ripper and I'm going to rip out the basting stitch so my invisible zipper can be exposed. So I'm just going to show a little bit of it. So I place my pin where I will stop. That's my stopping portion of where I want my zipper to come down to. And then I'm just ripping out my basting stitch. I know it's kind of hard to see it in the video, but I hope you can see a little bit of me ripping the basting stitches out. So, once you rip out the basting stitches, or however you inserted your zipper, go ahead and unzip your zipper to make sure that there's no fabric caught in the zipper or anything. And what you're going to do now is you can do this by using the machine, or you can do it by hand sewing. I cut off the top portion, the excess of my zipper, and then I placed with right side together. I just went ahead and pulled my lining over my zipper as far as I possibly can, and I will use my sewing machine and stitch this together. But you could also stitch or hand sew each end of the zipper tape to the seam allowance, making sure the back is free. And that's all you have to do. So thank you so much for watching. Rate, comment, and subscribe. Until next time.